ISUPK.
We are the ISUPK out of World West on Johnson 21st Street, Harlem, New York, under Commanding General Yohana. Yes, and since 1969, we have been teaching that Black, Hispanic, and Native Indians are the lost 12 tribes of Israel. Yes, and since 1969, we have been teaching that, and we will always be teaching the same thing over and over. Nothing has changed. From since biblical times to now, nothing has changed.
You understand? Give me a hand. Good.
Book of Jeremiah, chapter 28 and verse 8. The prophets that have been before me and before thee of old prophesy both against many countries and against great kingdoms of war.
Right? So we just prophesy against countries. We just pray for World War III to come. You understand? A lot of Christians just pray for peace. But the prophets used to be praying for war.
Right.
They used to prophesy for war.
Right.
And that is the same thing what we're saying here now. We prophesying for war.
Right.
We pray that World War III comes in the morning. You understand? That is a proof to show that we are prophets of the Lord.
Right. Right.
We are not Christians.
Right.
Christians want peace. But God and the prophets does always say the word war.
Right.
Right now I'm praying for World War III to come in the morning. I'm not a Christian. Christians praying for peace. But not seeing any peace. It ain't having no peace and Christians praying for peace.
Right.
It's only war you're seeing.
Right.
Because the prophets always used to pray for war.
Right.
Well.
And against great kingdoms of war and of evil and of pestilence.
Right. And of evil and pestilence. You understand? I pray tonight that every East Indian die of a heart attack in their sleep.
Right.
I pray tonight that every East Indian get the coronavirus.
Right.
Because them East Indians racist right. against Black people. Them East Indians making the Venezuelans fight amongst Black people.
Right.
That East Indians doing. Black man love the Venezuelans and the Venezuelans love Black people.
Right.
When I see the Venezuelan man fighting against the Venezuelan brother, that is how East Indians doing. I pray that all them East Indians get the coronavirus tonight.
Right.
That is why I pray. And the prophets used to pray for sickness and diseases. That was pestilence.
Right.
I saw you know who is prophet.
Right.
So when they say I'm coming out here and I say I pray that every East Indian die of a heart attack in their sleep, you know he's a prophet.
Right.
But if I pray for peace, you know he's a false prophet.
Right.
Right.
Verse 9, the prophet which prophesied of peace, when the word of the prophet shall come to pass.
Right, so you say when the prophets prophesying of peace, and peace really come to pass, who does prophesy of peace? Your Christian pastor does prophesy of peace. When?
Then shall the prophet be known.
Right, so if the pastor prophesying for peace, and it really, peace really happened on the earth, then you know the pastor is a prophet. But for since thousands of years, the pastor praying for peace, the pastor praying for this race to join hands with another race. For how much years they hear the pastor saying that? That means the pastor is a false prophet.
Right.
Because peace never existed when the pastor saying peace.
Right.
It's only war. And why war existed? Because the true prophets of God does always pray for war,
right,
and sickness.
Right.
And I pray, I thank the Lord for the coronavirus.
Right.
I pray every East Indian in Trinidad get the coronavirus.
Right.
Because all them East Indians is racist against black people.
Right. Right.
No, I thank you, ma'am.
All of the East Indians racist. And all of us should get the coronavirus.
Right.
No black man should get the coronavirus, only East Indians.
Right.
Because the East Indians nasty and racist against black people.
Right.
Although don't like black people.
Right.
Although using we for politics. Using we for to hold hands and say, alright, let me be your wife now. So when you marry, you can get everything.
Right.
Use we can't go in the bank for a loan. Because the East Indian loans officer are denying me the loan.
Right.
But they're going to give you a small $5,000 loan for me to keep coming back. You understand? The East Indians racist against black people, and every East Indian in Trinidad should get the coronavirus.
Right.
Yeah, right.
Book of Leviticus chapter 20 and verse 24. But I say unto you, ye shall inherit the land, and I will give it unto you to possess it, a land that floweth with milk and honey. I am the Lord your power, which have separated you from other people.
Right, so the Lord, black man, Hispanic and Native Indian man, the Lord separated us from all the races on the face of the earth. We should not join hands with no 1%. We should not join hands with the Chinese.
Right.
We should not join hands with them Africans and the white man.
Right.
And we definitely shouldn't join hands with them racist East Indians.
Right. Right.
You understand? We should be separate from them. That is what
right.
The Lord telling black people in the Bible. Separate yourself from every race. Because the Lord separated everybody on the face of the earth.
Right.
So who is we to say let me join hands with every race? Who is we to say join hands with every race and God say he separated everybody on the earth?
Right. Right.
Verse 25. Ye shall therefore put difference between clean beasts and unclean, and between unclean fowls and clean, and ye shall not make your souls abominable by beast or fowl, or by any manner of living thing that creepeth on the ground, which I have separated from you as unclean.
Right, so the Lord, once we separate yourself, black man, we gonna understand that the Lord gave us a dietary law. He told us what is clean and what is unclean. And spiritually, you understand? So apart from the animals that clean and unclean, spiritually them other races is unclean.
Right.
We should not be having sex with no East Indian woman.
Right.
You understand? We should be going with them Chinese and white people, black man.
Right.
The Lord separated everybody on the face of the earth.
Right.
So why you want to join hands with every race? Hey, black man, we the only race who love every race. But them other race hate black people.
Right.
Them other race hate the Venezuelans.
Right.
But the Venezuelans love everybody. You ain't see that we's curse? If you watch every race that going through oppression right now, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, their sign is in the Bible. The curses of the Lord is in the Bible. Right. With blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. That means that we is one race. And I am right for saying every East Indian should die of the coronavirus tonight.
Right.
Every East Indian should die.
Right.
Because they're racist against black people.
Right.
They don't like black people. You can't go in the bank and get a loan for a black man. I show all them brothers and Silas and John went into the bank for a loan. But the racist East Indian denying them the loan.
Right.
Because they're racist. I pray to God that every East Indian get the coronavirus tonight.
Right.
I pray.
Yes, I know.
Verse 26. And ye shall be holy unto me, for I, the Lord, am holy.
Right, so the Lord saying we shall be holy unto him. Holy means to set apart. If you set something apart, you are separate to that person.
Right.
The Lord saying we are separate people to all them other races. You understand? That's why we shouldn't vote. Because we vote in UNC and PNM for years. And the PNM and UNC just oppressing black people. Because why? The PNM don't have a mind of their own. The PNM love the oppressor because it's the oppressor who gained them the money and funded them to be in high positions. And one day, if a black man in the PNM starts to help black people, he's going to lose his position, just like how Nick Cannon had get fired from Viacom.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 20 and verse 26. And ye shall be holy unto me, for I, the Lord, am holy, and have severed you from other people, and ye should be mine.
Right, so the Lord said, he himself, apart from us being holy, the Lord is saying he is holy unto us. That means the Lord is only the Lord of Israel. The Lord is not the Lord of the Chinese and the white man and the East Indian.
Right.
The Lord is only the Lord for black people. If you want to see real powers, come in the ghetto and you will see real powers. Because why? God is only for black people. That's nothing if you are at the bottom of the table right now. Every race wants to be a black man.
Right.
They don't want to be us because they're oppressing us. But every race does watch us and do exactly what we do. Because the black man is diamond. He is gold. He is the salt on the earth.
Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7 and verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy power.
Right, so we as holy people unto the Most High. We as separate people again unto the Most High, the nation of Israel. Go ahead.
The Lord thy power hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Right, so if I have a shoe closet, you understand, and out of all the shoes, I will have a special shoes. You understand? That's what the Lord describing us as. Out of all the people on this earth, we is his special people. The Lord said, black man, you is my special people, and I will be your God. You understand? That was the Lord, that way we should not join hands with our oppressors. We shouldn't join hands with them racist East Indians. You understand? East Indians themselves just tell with their face that they're racist. And we are such slaves, black man. We just still go and shake hands with East Indians. You understand?
Give me a 10-8-1. You understand?
I pray to the Lord that every East Indian die of some heart attack in their sleep tonight. You understand? If they don't die from a heart attack, let them die from the coronavirus. Every East Indian. Because all of racist against black people.
Right. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 1. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy power, to observe and to do all his commandments.
Right,
which
so,
I come.
Right, so what going on here now? The Lord is saying, hey, if all listen to my voice and do what I tell all to do, black people. And the Lord's laws is not grievous and not hard. Just stop eating pork, crab, and shrimp. That hard to do? That ain't hard. You see a manicure running in the ground, leave the manicure alone. Don't go and catch the manicure and fry it and cook it. The Lord says stop eating manicure and rabbit and crab. That ain't hard, black man. You understand? Go ahead.
Slough, right? Mm. To observe and to do all its commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy power will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
Right, so the Lord say, if we keep his laws, black man, we would be above every race on the face of the earth. But because we sinned against the Lord, black man, we are at the bottom right now. But the Lord is saying, if we stop eating pork, crab, shrimp, and lobster, black people, we gonna be running the banks. We gonna be running the media industry. We gonna be running the diamond district. We gonna be running the earth, black man and Hispanic man. If we listen to the laws of God.
You understand? Give me Deuteronomy 17 and 15. You understand?
Every black man running to vote. What are they voting for?
You understand?
Yes, we voted. We voted UNC, PNM, ILP, Team Unity. We voted all kind of political parties and the black man still at the bottom. Why is that? It's because every politician hates black people. That is why the black man at the bottom. Every homeless person is seen on the street. Show me an East Indian. Yeah? Show me any East Indian that is a vagrant on the street.
Right.
It's only black people are seen.
Right.
Because black people are alone oppressed.
Right.
But we still, we so much slaves. We still running to vote PNM and UNC. Do not vote black man. Voting don't make sense.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 17 and verse 15. Thou shalt in any wise set them king over thee, whom the Lord thy God shall choose.
Right? So this scripture I'm bringing out here. The Lord told black people to do not vote. The Lord said he is going to put a king over the black man. And that king is Christ. Do not vote, black man. Anytime you vote, for years black people voted, and black people still running in the labas to get food, to eat. Black people still homeless, and it's years we voted. So what sense black people vote for? Do not vote, black people.
Right.
Those politicians using all you.
Right.
They using all the oppression against all you.
Right.
Why all you voting for?
Right.
They making all the vote to get 10 days in UIP. So look at Guamba going to kill all the black brother to get the next 10 days in URP. Do not vote, black man.
Right.
Let the Chinese and East Indians vote. What all I have to do is come in the school and learn that Christ is all ahead over all you.
Right.
No politician cannot lead black man. No politician cannot save a black man. Politicians does only bring guns and drugs in the black community.
Right, right.
Any politician, UNC, PNM, ILP, none of them gives a damn about black people.
Right.
That's why black man still suffering.
Right.
So why all are voting? Why all are voting? They say we have free education. But free education is a myth. Free education only exists for rich people. Free education is not for the poor person. You understand? They say we have free education, right? But what is free education? Free education is a myth. It does not exist for poor black people.
Right.
Once you're poor and you're black, you have no education. That is a lie. From since Eric Williams' days to now, the black man still suffering.
Right.
And he voted. What are you voting for?
Right.
Do not vote, black man. Because no matter who you vote for, you will always be running in the labas to get food to eat. You will always be homeless on the streets. You will always have black on black crime. Because no politician gives a damn about black people.
Right. Right.
You understand?
One from among thy brethren shall thou set king over thee. Thou mayest not set a stranger over thee, which is not thy brother.
Right, so the Lord is going to put a brethren over us. And that brethren is Jesus Christ, as you all know him. Jesus Christ is going to be the man who is ruling the nation of Israel.
Right.
You understand? You'll try every political leader, black man.
Right.
We'll try Jesus Christ now, nah?
Right.
But learn who is Jesus Christ. Because that image, what all are learning in church, is not Jesus Christ.
Right.
That image is Sija Bourget.
Right.
So come and learn the truth in this school.
Right.
Learn who Jesus Christ really is.
Right.
In the Bible.
Right.
Only he alone can save black people.
Right. Right.
No politician cannot save a black man.
Right.
All politicians just do is use the oppression against black people. But black people, we poor and we oppressed. So when they come with that $200 to make we bad talk another black man, we go take it and we go vote them because we get a scrawny little $200. because that's what black people is. We in hell. We poor and we oppressed. But black man, I'm telling you today, do not vote. Voting will only make things worse for you, black man.
Right.
You will never come out of oppression if you continue to vote. Stop voting. Voting does not make sense for right. black people. Yes, we voted, and nothing never happened for black people.
Right.
Black people still suffering.
Right.
So why we voting for? You know why we voting? Because we hoping that one day, the politicians will lead the black man out of hell. That is why we voting. We have no other choice because we poor and we oppressed. We don't know no better. But black man come in this school and we'll show you how Allah could change our life and how Allah could be free of oppression just by keeping the laws of the Bible.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, so packed, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's already turned from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good record. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom, the breath of life, I believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain. Something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord?